once in a church raffle. So yes, I do believe I'm one of life's winners.
Until you're a millionaire, there's always Britain's number one used car network. Network Q.
So who wants to be a millionaire Saturday night? And it's yell at your telly time once again. All over the country, everyone's getting ready to shout at their TV sets. But thankfully for our contestants, it's like that slogan in the movie Alien, in the hot seat, no one can hear you scream. Which is good news for this man back from last Saturday. This is Sid Rawcliffe, a writer from Accrington in Lancashire. Friend John is up there in the audience once again, while Sid's partner Di is watching at home with the kids Jay and Leon. Now, at this moment, Sid is on £8,000. He has two lifelines remaining, but with a really big win, he wants to take his horse racing mates, he talked about last week, the Jolly Boys, on a freebie to France. To the Lac de Triomphe.
Correct, Chris.
Which is the greatest horse racing event probably in the world, isn't it?
Yeah, certainly. Certainly in Europe, anyway.
So have you spoken to the Jolly Boys then? I suppose they've
been quite excited.
And what about Di? Now, what's Di made of your situation? Because you're on £8,000, which is good.
Yeah. She's warned me that if I lose it, I may lose parts of my anatomy.
Ah. She's a little harsh, Sid.
Yes.
You were saying earlier that you don't like this bit. I mean, you're here, you're in the seat, but yeah. This sort of £8,000 bit is the area that you... Yeah. When you watch it at home, you think, well, I wouldn't like that bit. Mm.
These two questions, I think... You know, you can. It's a big drop down to a grand, and it's a big jump up. But you get to 32,
you'll be a happy bunny.
I'll be happy.
Okay, well, now fingers crossed tonight. Yeah. Sid is on £8,000, so he, as we say, he has two lifelines still remaining. He's got phone a friend, and he can ask this brand new audience. And don't forget, if you at home see a prompt on screen, then press the red button on your remote to play along interactively. Okay, Sid, lots of luck. Let's play. Who wants to be a millionaire? Question number 9 is for £16,000. Here it comes, take your time, tell me what you want to do. Which of these men is not considered to be one of the Lake Poets? Robert Browning, Samuel Taylor Coleridge, Robert Southey, William Wordsworth. Is this as nasty as you thought it might be?
Yes.
Ah. Sid, remember your bits and pieces.
Yeah.
You want to go home with them?
Correct. It's definitely one of two.
It's definitely one of four.
But I know too that it's not. I think I'm going to have to phone a friend. I think.
Don't trust the audience, then.
I'll rely on them when it gets for more serious money.
Take your time, have a look. Yeah. Which of these men is not considered to be one of the Lake Poets? Robert Browning, Samuel Taylor Coleridge, Robert Southey, William Wordsworth. One of those is worth £16,000 to you.
Well, Wordsworth is a Lake Poet. I'm pretty sure Southey is. So that leaves Browning and Coleridge. Right, I'm going to have to phone a friend.
Okay. Now, who'd know?
I'll try Shirley.
Shirley? Okay. Want to tell her it's worth £16,000?
Yes, please, yeah.
OK, where's Shirley?
Shirley's up in Lancashire.
OK.
Hello?
Shirley?
Oh, hello.
Oh, it's Chris Tarrant here, good evening.
How do you do?
Well, I'm OK. Now, we're on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. Now, Sid's here, he's back in the chair. He's stuck on £8,000. Shirley, what it means is that, really and truly, with your help, we need an answer that's worth 16,000.
Okay.
So it's quite serious money. All right, my darling, next voice here will be Sid to tell her the question. There are four possible answers. One of these is worth £16,000 to him.
Okay.
Sid, 30 seconds. Good luck. Your time starts now.
Shirley, which of these men is not considered one of the Lake Poets? The Lake Poets. It's Browning, Coleridge, Southey, or Wordsworth. The Lake Poets. Browning, Coleridge, Southey, or Wordsworth.
Browning.
That's what I thought.
Yep, I'm definite.
Yep.
100%. Yep,
read
it. Know it.
Right. We'll go with that then, Chris.
Thought you might.
Yep.
Final answer?
Yeah.
How long have you known Shirley?
Oh, a good few years.
Have you? She's a good girl. Just won you £16,000. Other three were known as the Lake Poets because they all lived up in the Lake District. Now, you got 16,000. Big old drop here, but everything to play for. You have one lifeline left. You're saving the audience for the really hard stuff.
Yep.
Good plan, Sid. maybe. But you could lose £15,000 here. You could walk away with 16,000, Sid. Have a look at it. Question number 10 of a possible 15. What was the first name of Starsky in the US TV series Starsky and Hutch? Dave, Mitch, Steve, Jim.
I think I might be coming to the audience yet.
First name of Starsky.
Yeah. I never watched Starsky and Hutch. I just don't know this. No, I'm going to have to ask the audience, Chris.
Don't say it like that. You're going to have to ask the audience.
Yeah.
They might know.
Yeah.
OK, right, audience, serious business. This is worth £32,000. On your keypads, please. This is the question. What was the first name of Starsky in the US TV series Starsky and Hutch? All on your keypads, please. All vote now.
That's pretty conclusive, isn't it? I think. Yeah, I'm going to trust this audience.
Sid.
I may lose
there's 200 complete strangers. Well, 199 and John.
I'm going to go with the audience. And I may lose bits of my anatomy into the business.
But... Oh, Sid, you will. Final answer.
Yes, I'll go with that.
Even though you never, ever saw it.
Never saw it.
You're trusting 200 complete strangers sitting here in total darkness.
Yes, I am, Chris.
You just won £32,000. Well done, audience.
Thank you.
What an audience. And you can go back up to Actrington with everything you had when you came. And a little bit more. I'll tell you what, Sid, that was very brave. It was also slightly mad, but it was very brave.
Yeah. That's wonderful.
That is just wonderful.
Absolutely wonderful, Chris.
Well, you certainly rode it there. How do you feel?
Great, now.
Thought you might.
Yeah.
Well, now, you have no more lifelines, but you have £32,000, which is guaranteed. Whatever happens, you go home tonight with that. Have a look at number 11. This is for £64,000. You might as well play this. You can't lose on it. Have a look at it. The word kismet, meaning fate, comes originally from which language? Russian, Latin, Swahili, Arabic.
Well, it's certainly not Latin, and it's certainly not Swahili.
How much Swahili do you know, Sid?
Jambo buana.
Just the two words then.
Kwaheri buana.
Oh, sorry, four words.
It's got to be Russian or Arabic.
Take your time, it's worth 64,000.
Yeah. I have a very strong feeling for Arabic. It could be Russian, but I'm much stronger feelings for Arabic. Yeah. I'm going Arabic. Final answer, Chris.
Mm. OK, we'll take a break. Join us again in a couple of minutes for the second part of tonight's Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? Don't go away.
Yeah, everything was going fine. Until he told me I could phone a friend.
Your colour should look as natural as nature intended. Garnier Bell Colour with natural ingredients understands how to work with your hair's own tones and highlights. So whether you colour to change or just to cover grey, you'll always have the most natural colour for you. Garnier Bell Colour. Garnier.
I'm Mr. Busnick's anger management therapist.
Dave Busnick's doctor is moving into his home.
I think you'll be pleasantly surprised how much fun we can have.
Whoa!
And into his life.
How about a kiss?
I'd love a kiss.
I think she's talking to me.
Jack Nicholson.
I'm gonna need for you to retard your anger.
It's retarded. I'm retarded.
Adam Sandler.
This guy grow up near a nuclear power plant or something?
Marissa Tomei.
How was the doctor?
Great! Anger management.
To wax, try new Veep Wax Strips. They're for sensitive skin. Your legs will stay feeling smooth for up to 3 whole weeks, long after you've given up feeling wimpy. Feet, a feeling that lasts.
Greed is good. In fact, it's delicious. Magnum Greed. Dark chocolate and tiramisu. Limited edition. One of the 7 deadly sins from Wolves.
Experience the essence of the Orient.
Sorry.
Lily and Rice Flour, a new fragrance from Comfort and Comfort Vaporess.
This is a new scratch card from the lottery, which is called Connect 4. You can win up to £44,444.
I need a holiday. Get me out of here.
The Mail has thousands and thousands of blue sky holidays that must be won.
Where to?
You choose.
You're joking.
And you choose when to go too. Beaches.
Cruises.
Activity holidays.
Family holidays.
Luxury hotels.
And villas.
And there's up to £200 worth of holiday vouchers.
Absolutely free for every reader.
Not booked your holiday yet? Start playing I Need a Holiday. Get me out of here. Only in tomorrow's Mail on Sunday.
Lucky jumpers! Welcome back to the second part of tonight's Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? Right now, Sid Rawcliffe is in the chair. Now, before the break, he got this question for £64,000. The word kismet, meaning fate, comes originally from which language? Russian, Latin, Swahili, or Arabic? I can't be bothered. You've just won £64,000.
Yes! 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 Yes!
I like it.
I thought you might. Yeah. Oh, let's not drag it out anymore tonight. It's in £64,000. That's right. Give me that.
Yeah.
Spot on. Your thinking was absolutely right. It's going rather well, Sid, isn't it?
Now it is,
I'm not worrying about your 8,000. This is all because of this audience.
Yeah, and they did a brilliant job.
Brilliant job. Right there. Take that.
Thank you very much.
£64,000. What will you do with that? That's rather a lot of money now.
Yeah, well, that's a trip to China.
New kitchen roof, mortgage.
It's all sorted out, it's all planned.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Might even be enough for a drink for me.
Well, I hope there's a drink for me, actually. Right, you got £64,000. You have no lifelines. You guarantee £32,000. But question number 12, if you did go for it and give me a right answer, is worth £125,000. You're four away from a million. Here it comes. Which organisation was formed as a result of the Bretton Woods Conference of 1944? Greenpeace, World Bank, Interpol, Oxfam. That's worth £125,000.
I said if I got to this position that I would go for it if I had a strong feeling. 64,000 is a lot of money, Chris. It's BOD, I'm sure it's BOD. It's not Greenpeace, it's far too early. And Interpol, no, I don't. I think Interpol was founded in Vienna. So it's BOD. I think it's the World Bank. I'll never be in this position again, Chris. I'm 75% World Bank, 20% Oxfam, 2%, no, I don't think it's any, 75, 25 for World Bank. I'm going to play, Chris. It's a lot of money to lose, but it's a lot of money to gain, and I might know, question.
Why do you think it's World Bank?
I've just got that feeling, just something that's sticking in the back of my mind. Yeah, I'm going to play, Chris. I'll never get this opportunity again.
That's true.
32,000.
You got that, that's guaranteed.
That's guaranteed. I've had a wonderful time down here. Been superb. I'm going to play. My final answer is World Bank, Chris.
I can tell you that 13% of this audience think it's Greenpeace. 29% think it's World Bank. 15% think it's Interpol. 43% think it's Oxfam. The 29% who think it's World Bank are right. You've just won 100.
Yes! 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 Yes!
£125,000. Sim, what a man! Yeah. That is the sort of spirit that gets you all the way. Quite pleased then, Sid.
All right. I'm relaxed.
Yes!
I'm relaxed now, Chris. I was really, really nervous before
Fantastic.
I came on.
Fantastic.
Now it's fine. Everything's fine.
I think it probably is.
Yeah.
The small detail of a cheque I gave you there about 5 minutes ago for £64,000. Whatever happens, you will not be going home with that. You will either go home with £32,000 or at least this cheque. Have a look. That's where you are now.
That is very serious money, isn't
it,
Chris?
It's serious money. Take it. You won it.
That's fantastic.
You deserve that as well. You did that really bravely. Really playing your hunches. If you give me a right answer to the next question, number 13, it's worth a quarter of a million. You've got £32,000 guaranteed. If you do give me a wrong answer to this next question, you lose £93,000.
That hurts.
Not good, Sid.
No.
But it's your call. Have a look at question number 13. You're three away from a million. This is worth £250,000.
Right, Chris.
The jazz musician Lester Young is best known for his virtuosity on which musical instrument? Drums, piano, saxophone, guitar. It's worth £250,000.
No, I'm not going to play on this. I really don't know. And £125,000 completely transforms my life, Chris. I know that my friend John will know this.
Look at his little face up there.
I know he'll know this. He's a jazz buff.
Yes, but Sid, it's question 13. He hasn't known anything of the other 12.
I know. I really...
I'd just be guessing, Chris, and that would be stupid with this much money. I'd love to go on. But, no, I mean, I've had a wonderful, wonderful time.
You've been amazing. You've been brilliant.
Yeah. The audience have been superb. I can't thank them enough. No, Chris, I'm passing. I'm folding my hands. That's great. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. OK, give him a big hand. Sid Rawcliffe goes away. £125,000 better off. You know, you said him up there, he'll know the answer. John will know the answer, you said. John actually reckoned the answer was C, saxophone.
That's where I would have gone. But whatever. I wouldn't have played. No point playing on that.
Do you know, I'd love to say to you now the answer was drums. It was saxophone. Give him a big hand. He goes away with £125,000. Well played, Sid. What a great night.
Yeah.
What up? Oh, what a lad. Sid Rawcliffe goes back to Lancashire, a very jolly boy with a cheque for a massive £125,000. Now we have 10 very eager brand new contestants, all very keen to follow Sid into the hot seat this Saturday night. Let's meet them. They are Kevin Allen from London, Mike Merwick from Berkshire, Tony Barker from London, Marine Munderidge from South Gloucestershire, Martin Grant from West Yorkshire, Kathleen Watt from Lanarkshire, Bob Eccles from Buckinghamshire, Michelle Greenall from Kent, Dan Cannon from Renfrewshire, and David Ainsworth from London. Ah, what a lineup. Right now, it's time for Fastest Finger First. Remember, there will be four answers, but only one correct order. You get that right in the fastest time, and you'll be next to play for a possible £1 million. Nice and quiet, please, in the audience. They need a bit of thinking time. Here comes the question. Starting with the smallest number, put the answers to these calculations in order. So four sums, four calculations coming up. We want the smallest answer going up to the largest. Here they come. 6 halves, 6 cubed, 6 to the power 6, 6 squared. 8 faces. Nice and easy then. Right, let's see. 10 start. This is the right order. This is the correct answer in the right order. 6 halved, that's actually 3. 6 squared is 36. 6 cubed is 216. Then 6 to the power of 6 is actually 46,656. Right, so let's see. That's the right order. Let's see if all 10 got it right. I suspect they did. Most of them did, actually. Martin Grant was fastest. That's you, Martin Grant. So good looking round. You're the only Martin Grant here. 5.05 seconds. You take your glasses off, Martin. You're going to pay for £1 million.
Sure do.
Pretty good. Right, we've already given away £125,000 tonight. Let's try and top that up. Here we have Martin Grant, a forklift truck driver from Wakefield, West Yorkshire. And up in the audience is his best friend, Ian, as Martin's partner, Wendy, is away in Europe. Martin says he's a bit of a daydreamer, but has been trying to use this to his advantage over the past few days by visualising me giving him a cheque, a very big cheque. Martin insists he's here to win £1 million. Nothing else, £1 million, and he's prepared to take risks to get there. I'll tell you what, it certainly worked for Sid. Now, if Martin gets stuck on the way, he has three lifelines to help him, as usual, he has 50-50. He can phone a friend, and of course, he can ask this very good audience. Right, Martin, let's try and get you up to at least £1,000. Let's make a start. Let's play Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? So we're up there at the dizzy heights of question number 13. We're back down to the bottom. Let's try and go all the way up. Question number one is for £100. Here it comes. Who present Saturday Night Takeaway on ITV1? Anton Deck, Jack and Vera, Tony and Cherie, Liz and Phil.
Anton Deck.
You've got £100. OK, Martin, no problem. Question number two for £200. Here it comes. Which of these words means the time by which something must be done? Hairline, Beeline. Deadline. Breadline.
Deadline.
That's the right answer. You got £200. Question number three is for 300. Have a look. Which part of the body is most likely to be affected by palpitations? Finger. Heart. Foot. Hair.
Heart.
You have £300. It's usually caused by anxiety or exertion.
I've got them.
I thought you might have. Question number four is for £500. What would be needed to play a game of Find the Lady? Dice. Cards. Pencil and paper. String.
Cards.
You've got £500. It's also called a three-card trick. Right. Martin, serious moment. Last point, you can go home with nothing at all, but it would guarantee you £1,000 if you give the right answer to question number five. Here it comes. Which of these is a small upright collar? Satsuma. Clementine. Tangerine. Mandarin.
I haven't got a clue. I think I'm going to have to ask the audience, Chris, because I just haven't got a clue.
OK, that's what lifelines are for.
So, yeah, I'll ask the audience, please.
OK, right. Audience, on your keypads, please, let's make sure Martin gets up to at least 1,000. This is the question. Which of these is a small, upright collar? Now, A on your keypads is Satsuma. B is Clementine. C is Tangerine. D is Mandarin. All vote now. ...86% are saying Mandarin.
Had I guessed, I'd have gone for Mandarin, so...
You little liar, Martin.
I would. If my life depended on it, I'd have gone for Mandarin, but I'll go with the audience, thank you.
Final answer?
Yes, please.
It's the right answer. You have £1,000. That's exactly what lifelines are for. Martin Grant still has two more, and he is 10 away from £1 million. We'll take a break. Join us again in a couple of minutes for the third part of tonight's Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? Don't go away.
I knew the first James Bond was Barry Nelson. Pity that wasn't a question.
Buy a pair of Boots brand glasses with hard-coated lenses and choose a pair of prescription sunglasses or 30 pairs of daily contact lenses free. Eye Care Solutions from Boots Opticians.
Need a hand, mate?
Oh, yeah, that'd be great.
Then join the AA.
Why didn't I join the AA? I thought I'd save them money. I wanted to buy these jeans.
You can join the AA from as little as £39, about the price of those jeans, and they fix around 8 out of 10 cars at the roadside. Call 0800 444 999. Just ask.
Casper,
it's me.
Yeah, listen, I've got the test results back. Some sort of lice. Lice! Well, these things can jump 6 foot, apparently. Yeah. They live in the air and then burrow right under the skin. Lay their eggs in the follicles. No, the follicles. Look, I can hardly hear you, mate.
Excuse me.
Some chats are better from home.
Yeah, he's well on the mend. Special powder's worked a treat. Isn't it, mate, eh?
New Cart Door Fruit and Fresh, a unique, refreshing blend of dairy ice cream and fresh yogurt, swirled with strawberries, red currants and raspberries.
If it's not fruit and fresh, shut the cart door.
Hi.
Sweat only attracts other men. Is that all you want? New Lynx Dry and antiperspirant. Avoid sweat. Attract women.
Hello, Vera.
All the kindness of Persil Aloe Vera, now in a liquid. A drop of nature, awash with kindness. To protect my skin, I found the Guardian Angel.
New solar expertise by L'Oreal. An innovation, the first skin-caring sun protection with Activa Cell. It improves the quality of your skin. Its advanced protection multiplies skin defense levels. L'Oreal Solar Expertise, its formula with Activa Cell improves skin quality.
Protected, my skin is beautiful.
New Solar Expertise by L'Oreal.
You're worth it.
Julie! Spotted the old DIY, eh?
Take cover! You get blown away!
Ah, it's just a passing shower.
Hang on. Four of you?
Three of you, one of me, the Great British Summer. I make that Pim's O'Clock, don't you?
Knew he'd be back.
If nothing else, I'm rich in memories.
Welcome back to the third part of tonight's Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? At this moment, Martin Grant's in the hot seat. He's on £1,000, he's guaranteed that. He has two lifelines remaining. But Martin says, I am coming here for a million and I will take nothing less.
That's not strictly true.
But Grant's quite good, actually, Chris. That's not the confidence out of you, hasn't it?
It's unbelievable. I just can't.
You've seen it happen. Everybody at home is.
I've actually sat at home and watched it happen on £500, on £200.
It does happen, and we all say this thing. It sounds very trite, but they're only easy if you know the answer. It is so true of the show. You were at school with Ian Duncan Smith.
I was.
How was he?
I remember him as being a fairly okay guy. Yeah.
Was he a bald boy?
No, he wasn't. No,
was he not?
No.
Yeah, big thick.
Black hair. Yeah.
Dreadlocks.
Not quite. I mean, no. It was a strange school. Short hair was the order of the day.
Yeah, and also, one of the guys you played rugby with was Clive Woodward.
Clive was a good friend. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And he did all right, didn't he?
He did. I mean, you could tell. I mean, I knew from his first days of playing rugby, and I was with him for 4 or 5 years, that there was something special about him. And he would play for England one day.
Certainly produced a very special team.
He certainly has.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Serious business there, Martin. You have £1,000. You have two lifelines intact. You are 10 away from a million. Question number 6 is for £2,000. Here it comes. Which of these is usually found in a salade niçoise? Tuna. Bacon. Walnuts. Apple.
Tuna, Chris.
Sure.
Pretty much.
Not walnuts.
Possibly, but tuna's...
No bacon?
No, I think it's tuna. In fact, I'm sure it's tuna.
Final answer?
Yeah.
It's the right answer. You've got £2,000. You were flying along. That thing about satsumas and tangerines has really thrown you.
That really has. Yeah.
Listen, take your time. Question number 7 is for £4,000. Santa Barbara and Santa Ana are in which American state? Washington, Hawaii, Florida, California.
California, Chris.
Final answer.
Yeah.
The right answer. You've got £4,000. You're getting palpitations again, aren't you?
It's the way you looked at me then. I thought, oh.
I look like this every week. I always look like this. I can't help it.
Yeah. You're supposed to give people confidence.
I've given you confidence.
No, you're giving me palpitations.
Sorry. Right. You have £4,000. You ever seen the show before? I always look like this. You've got £4,000. Question number 8 is for £8,000. You have a 50-50, you have a phone a friend still. Here it comes. Which comedian formerly managed the band Suede? Ricky Gervais, Harry Hill, Sean Hughes, Julian Clary.
I simply don't know.
Now, who would?
I think I'm going to have to ring Alan.
Okay. Who's Alan?
He's a mate I've known through work for many a long year, and he's also a DJ, and he's into music, so hopefully he'll know the answer to this, because I don't.
Okay, where's Alan?
He's in Wakefield.
Hello?
Alan?
Yeah?
Chris Tarrant, good evening.
Hello, Chris.
Hiya, we're on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, as you probably guess.
Yeah, I have, yeah.
Well, exactly. Now, Ms. Martin's here, Martin Grant. He's doing okay, actually. He's on £4,000. He's stuck on one particular one. Ali says, you're the man to help him.
Okay, mate.
Okay. Next voice here will be Martin's. He'll have 30 seconds to tell her the question. There are still four possible answers. One of these is worth £8,000. All right,
mate.
Okay, Martin, lots of luck. Your time starts now.
Alan.
Hello, Matt.
Hiya. Which comedian formerly managed the band Suede? Ricky Gervais, Harry Hill, Sean Hughes, or Julian Clary?
Give me those again,
man,
quickly.
Ricky Gervais, Harry Hill, Sean Hughes, or Julian Clary?
Got
10 seconds.
I've got an idea, Martin, but I don't think it's good enough to get you there.
Okay.
I would have gone.
Oh. We'll never know his idea, will we? Now, what do you want to do? You got a 50-50, but if you haven't a clue, it may not help.
Well, I'm going to have to go for the 50-50, Chris, please.
OK. Computer, take away two wrong answers. Leave Martin the right answer and one remaining random wrong answer. You got 4,000. One of those is worth 8,000. One of those would cost you 3,000.
I'm going to have to guess.
You don't have to.
I do.
You do? Apparently.
I'll go for Harry Hill.
Why?
I don't think it's Ricky Gervais. I don't know why. Don't associate him with pop music, associate him with writing and acting rather than managing.
You could walk away with 4,000.
No. I'll go for Harry Hill.
Final answer.
Final answer.
Get £4,000. You just lost £3,000, Martin. It was Ricky Gervais. But you do still go away with £1,000. I am sorry, mate.
That's okay.
All right, well played. He still goes away with £1,000. Cheers, mate. Well, Martin went away absolutely shattered. Martin Grant goes back to West Yorkshire, still with £1,000. Now, we have 9 contestants left to play Fastest Finger First again. Nice and quiet, please, in the audience. Here comes the next question. Starting with the smallest, put these cooking measures in order. Heaped teaspoon, pinch, level teaspoon, half a teaspoon. Okay, let's see. We've got 9 left. Let's see how many got it right. This is the right order. Starting with the smallest, a pinch. Then it's half a teaspoon. Then it's a level teaspoon. And then fairly obviously, it's a heaped teaspoon. So that's the right order. Now, 9 left. How many got it right out of 9? Most of them actually. Now, who was faster? Kathleen Watt in 4.03 seconds. Kathleen, it's you. Hi, man. You want to play for £1 million? Oh, yes. So, this is Kathleen Watt, a civil servant from Glasgow in Scotland. Her husband, John, looking very proud, is up there in the audience, and they have a 7-year-old son, Lewis, hoping for a holiday to Florida if Mummy does well in the hot seat. Brother Jim is a possible phone friend that has told her, don't waste time saying hello when Chris calls, just get on and ask me the question. Which could be very good advice. I mean, Kathleen doesn't want everyone watching to think she's rude. Is that right?
That's correct. Okay, well, so I'm not saying straight into the question. I'll definitely say hello.
Let's get you up to £1,000 at least. 15 questions, 3 new lifelines, £1 million. That's the formula. OK, Kathleen, lots of luck. Let's play Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? So, back down the bottom again. Let's go racing back up to the top. Question number one is for £100. Here it comes. Which of these phrases means be quiet? Buckle up. Braces up. Bag up. Belt up.
Belt up.
You have £100. No problem. Good job. Question number two is for 200. You have all three lifelines. Here it is. When someone suddenly emerges from obscurity, they are said to come out of the what? Needlework. Metalwork. Woodwork. Patchwork.
Woodwork.
That's the right answer. You've got £200. Question number three. Have a look. Complete the proverb, lucky at cards, unlucky at dice, with choice, on ice, in love.
I don't really know that one. Could I ask the audience, Chris?
You can. Audience, on your keypads, please. Here comes Kathleen's question. It's for 300 quid. Complete the proverb, lucky at cards, unlucky, dot, 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 question mark, A, B, C, or D. It's worth £300. All vote now. Uh, 96%. That's quite high, Kathleen.
Yes, yes. I think I'll go with the audience.
Thought you might. Love. Can I just warn you that 7% of this audience think a satsuma is a kind of collar?
I think I'll trust them in this one.
OK, it's the right answer. You have £300. We'll play. Lucky at cards, unlucky in love. Right, you still have two lifelines. Let's get you up to at least 1,000. Question number four is for £500. Here it comes. A dish traditionally eaten on Thanksgiving Day in America is pumpkin what? Salad. Crumble. Pie. Stew.
Pie, Chris.
That's the right answer. You've got £500. Right, Kathleen, have a good look at this, but this would guarantee you £1,000. It's question number five. You still have phone a friend and you still have a 50-50. If you need them, you probably won't. Here it comes. Gunmetal is a shade of which colour? Green, red, grey, orange. What do you think?
Believe it or not, I've got two colours in my head and I'm not really too sure what one it is.
Gunmetal, shade of which colour? Green, red, grey, orange.
I think grey. Grey, Chris.
It's the right answer. You have £1,000. You're looking at me like it's a box of vipers. It's there are no trick questions. You have £1,000 guaranteed, which is good. OK? You're 10 away from a million, you have two lifelines, you still have 50-50, and you can phone a friend or possibly phone your brother. You're from a big family, aren't you, yourself?
Yes, I am. I'm
how many?
One of seven children.
Seven?
Yes.
It is a big family.
It is.
One of the things you want, I find this rather sweet, one of the things you want is a king-size bed.
Yes.
How tall are you?
4'11".
And how tall is John?
Over 5 foot.
You don't need a king size bed, you disappear. Well, I'm not being uncomfortable, perhaps it does sound a bit, I don't mean to be, but that's a huge bed.
I wriggle about a bit.
Do you know, I could die a happy man. Right, well, you have £1,000. So this is for Kathleen, question number six, for Kathleen who wriggles about a bit. You have two lifelines, my darling, you still have 50-50, and you can phone a friend. In which county is the town of Stroud? East Sussex, Cambridgeshire, Devon, Gloucestershire.
I have to say...
it's a long way south of Glasgow, isn't it?
Haven't a clue. Geography is one of my worst subjects. And I would rather phone a friend just now.
Okay.
Because I know 50-50 won't help me.
Who are you going to phone?
I'll phone my mother-in-law, Sandra.
Your mother, not your brother?
No.
Oh, OK. Mother and old Sandra, okay. Is she Glasgow?
Yes.
Hello?
Sandra?
Yes.
It's Chris Tarrant. Good evening.
Oh, good evening, Chris.
I've got Catherine here. She's doing okay. She's in the chair.
Yes.
John, your boy's looking a bit anxious sitting up there, but not she's okay. Now, she's on £1,000.
Oh, good.
With your help, she's stuck on a particular question, Sandra. She says you're the woman to get her through.
Oh, I hope so.
Well, I hope so. It's worth £2,000. Now, the next voice you'll be Catherine, she'll tell you the question. There are four possible answers, and one of them's worth £2,000. Okay.
Okay, love, thanks.
Right, Catherine, 30 seconds. Good luck. Your time starts now.
Hi, Sandra.
Hi.
Which county is the town of Stroud? East Sussex, Cambridgeshire, Devon, Gloucestershire?
I think it's Gloucestershire.
How sure, Sandra?
About 60%.
That's excellent. Thank you.
Okay, darling.
Right,
I'm
bye.
Not absolutely certain, but I'm almost certain it's in Gloucestershire.
That's more than I know. Thank you.
Okay, darling. Good luck.
I'll go for Gloucestershire.
She's sounding very nice for a mother-in-law.
She's lovely.
Final answer?
Final answer.
She's a very, very nice mother-in-law. It's the right answer. You got £2,000. So, Kathleen Ward is on £2,000. She still has one lifeline. She has a 50-50. And at this moment, she is nine away from a million. We'll take a break. Join us again in a couple of minutes for the final part of tonight's Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? Don't go away.
Oh, my God, it's gorgeous. How many carats did you say it was?
Now, there are some incredible offers at Boots. First, we have buy one, get one free on selected sun care products within Sultan, Ombre Solaire, L'Oreal Solar or Nivea Sun. What's more, receive a free Boots Colour 35mm or APS film when you use the Boots 1-hour film processing service, now available at most Boots stores.
Free Pepsi with your 10-piece mega bucket, only $9.99.
If you're too wimpy to wax, try new Veep Wax Strips. They're for sensitive skin. Your legs will stay feeling smooth for up to 3 whole weeks. Long after you've given up feeling wimpy. Feet, a feeling that lasts.
Walls-Cart Doors Spaniola. Delicious vanilla ice cream mixed with rich cherry sauce and topped with real cherries.
If it's not Spaniola, shut the car door.
Women look great in black, but not if their antiperspirant leaves white marks. Unlike some antiperspirants, new Sure Crystal contains Clear-X, so it's unbeatable at minimising white marks.
New Dove Firming Lotion with grapeseed extract, ceramides, and active moisturisers. Be firm with your skin.
The frizz monster can strike at any time. So try new Sunsilk Frizz Control Cream. Be prepared. Tame your frizz.
New Sif Oxygel with active oxygen formula. It's like having outdoor freshness indoors. New Sif Oxygel.
The fresh taste of Ocean Spray chilled cranberry juice drinks is indescribably delicious. Just leave the juicing to us. Ocean spray. There's definitely something in it.
There's something I need to know. John Forsyth.
What about him?
To lose our son to Soames.
We won't tell him about us, and that's that.
We've fallen in love.
I'm scared, Julian.
It must have been a scandal. Who are you to tell me what I should do and who I should love?
What if I've lost?
The Forsyth saga continues Sunday at 9, ITV1.
Welcome back to the fourth part of tonight's Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? Kathleen Watt is in the hot seat. She's on £2,000. She still has that one vital lifeline remaining. Mother-in-law just got you up to £2,000. How are you feeling?
Quite nervous.
Are you? You're doing okay? You got 2,000?
Yes.
On your way to your king-size bed?
Yes, I will definitely get my king-size bed.
Okay. You have £2,000. You have a 50-50 left. Money goes up now quite steeply. You're 9 away from a million, but question number 7 is worth £4,000. Have a look at it. Kathleen, tell me what you want to do. In 2003, what did New York ban during theatre performances? Large hats. Mobile phones. Sweets. Newspapers. Now, it's worth £4,000 to you.
What I thought was going to come up didn't.
What were you thinking would come up?
I thought smoking. I wasn't sure if it had been earlier that they would have banned that. And the Americans can be quite bizarre for what they want to ban at the best of times. Can I go 50-50, please, Chris?
You can. The computer take away two wrong answers. Leave Kathleen the right answer and the one remaining random wrong answer. So you've got large hats or mobile phones. One of those is worth £4,000.
Don't think it's large hats, Chris. I'm going to gamble for mobile phones.
Final answer.
Final answer.
Mobile phones. It's the right answer. That's exactly what they did ban in 2003. You've got £4,000. Now, you've got £4,000. That's your last lifeline, though. What did you say when you and John came down? What did you think? Well, if we could get that, that would be good.
8,000.
Okay. You have £4,000. Kathleen, you can obviously walk away with that £4,000. If you give me a wrong answer at this point, you've still got that £1,000, but you would lose £3,000. Question number 8 is for £8,000, but you do not have to play this question. Here it comes. What nationality is the pop singer Samantha Mumba? Australian. Irish. South African, Canadian.
She's Irish, Chris.
How do you know?
I like her songs.
You what?
I like her songs, I like her music.
Sure?
Positive.
Can I play?
Yes, please.
Final answer.
Final answer.
You've just won £8,000. Which is the amount you wanted. Feel good?
Excellent.
Excellent. Right, now, Kathleen, whatever you do, do not lose this amount of money. You have 8,000, but you only have 8,000 to take when you say to me, I'm going to take it away. If you gave me a wrong answer at this point, you would lose £7,000. Question number 9, though, you're on a bit of a roll. Question number 9 is worth £16,000. You are 2 away from £32,000. Take your time, have a look at it. Here it comes. Which English queen ruled jointly with her husband from 1689 to 1694? Elizabeth I, Mary II, Anne, Victoria.
I've no idea, Chris, and I've won my 8,000. I'm quite happy to walk away now, so I'll take the money, please.
Final answer, you can take the money.
Final answer, I'm taking the money.
Happy? 8,000?
Very. Yes.
You look really pleased. Give her a big hand. She goes away with £8,000. Before you go, Kathleen, before you go. I don't think you could actually care less, but I can tell you the right answer actually is B there. Mary the Second is the right answer. Okay, but you go away £8,000 better off with a huge grin on your face. Well played, my darling. Really well done. Bless you. But she was very pleased. Kathleen Watt goes racing back to Glasgow with £8,000, and the cheque was almost as big as her. Now we have 8 contestants left to play. Fastest finger first, nice and quiet, please. Here comes the next question. Put these breeds of dog in alphabetical order. Poodle, pug, Pekingese, papillon. Eight left, 6 men, 2 women. The fingers were a blur on that. Let's see. First and foremost, then, let's check. It's fairly straightforward, but of course they had to do it against each other at speed. Papillon, P-A-P. And then it's P-E-K. Then fairly obviously P-O-O. And then it's pug, P-U-G. So that's the right order. Now, 8 left. Did 8 get it right? Let's have a look. 7 got it right. Who was fast? Tony Barker in 3.39 seconds. Tony! You look sort of glazed. You all right?
Yes, I'm all right.
Want to play for £1 million?
Yes, please.
Oh, yes, please. Right, here we have Tony Barker, a money broker from South Norwood in London. His friend Mark is up there in the audience, and Tony has 2 kids, Sam and Dom. With a big win, Tony's workmates are expecting a big night out, even though they have been teasing Tony, who likes his food, by asking, are you going on that show, Who Wants to Eat a Million Pies? Very unkind. 15 questions, 3 new lifelines, £1 million. OK, Tony, lots of luck. Let's play. Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? Question number 1 for £100. Here it comes. Which of these means to mix socially, especially with those considered to be of a higher social status? Digestive, rich tea, hobnob, custard cream.
Hobnob, Chris.
Hobnob is the right answer. Tony, you got £100. Question number 2 for £200. Complete this saying by hook or by dot, dot, dot. Book, look, crook, nook.
Crook, Chris.
You got the right answer, £200. Question number 3 is for £300. Which of these is a type of embroidery? Pinpoint, needlepoint, 3 pinpoint, pencil point.
Needle point, Chris.
That's the right answer. You got £300. Number 4 is for £500. You're 2 away from 1,000. Rosa is a slang term for which of these? A policeman, a fireman, ambulance driver, soldier.
Well, my dad was one of these, a policeman.
A Rosa. It's £500. The right answer. I'm afraid that's all we've got time for now. Earlier on this evening, Sid Rawcliffe went away with a massive £125,000. Martin Grant took home £1,000. Kathleen Watt went back up to Scotland, absolutely delighted, £8,000 better off. Tony Barker here ends the show on £500, but he does have all 3 lifelines remaining. He's back, we're back next Saturday, but the cash point is now closed for tonight. The phone lines are shut for this series, but don't forget you can still play Who Wants to Be a Millionaire online. The prize is totaling £10,000 this month on ITV.com. We're back next Saturday with another Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. Good night.
And don't forget, Tarrant's back with more Millionaire hopefuls tonight at 8.
Who's going to win the 3:30 next Saturday at Epsom? Now there's a £1 million question.
Until you're a millionaire, you can always rely on Network Q.
Spring has sprung. The sap is rising.
and it's time to visit some very dear friends.
Perfect!
Starring David Jason, Pam Ferris.
Hello.
And Catherine Zeta-Jones.
I love you, Mariette.
The Darling Buds of May, Monday at 9 on ITV1.
Roger.
Excuse me.
Start the car. They're onto us.
A lost passport on holiday can lead to all kinds of unpleasant excursions. But now, if you take American Express Traveler's Checks, with just one free call, we'll help you get a new one. Giving you essential advice and, where possible, arranging an interview for you. Helping you spend your holiday on holiday.
The way state pensions, war pensions and benefits are paid is changing. It's called direct payment. Put simply, your money will be paid straight into your account. Order books and gyros are being phased out, and this new way has some advantages. First off, your pension or your benefit gets paid into your account automatically. Same amount as regularly as now. Secondly, you'll be able to get your money out in many, many more places, including the post office. Also, you'll only ever have to carry as much or as little cash as you need, not all of it at once. If you've already got a bank account, changing to direct payment is a walk in the park. If you haven't got a bank account, you can get straightforward information on all your options and how to open one. If you use an order book or gyro, you'll be getting a letter and a leaflet explaining your options and what to do next. But for more information, call 0800 107 2000.
Direct payment, giving it to you straight.
Keeping yourself dry underwater has never been easy, so it's good to know you can rely on Aqua Protect from Elastoplast. They're not only waterproof, they form a watertight seal around the wound, keeping it completely dry. Aqua Protect from Elastoplast. We help to heal.
Need a hand, mate?
Oh, yeah, that'd be great.
Then join the AA.
Why didn't I join the AA? I thought I'd save them money. I wanted to buy these jeans.
You can join the AA from as little as £39, about the price of those jeans, and they fix around 8 out of 10 cars at the roadside. Call 0800 444999. Just ask.
There's something to celebrate at DFS with at least 50% off everything in the springtime collection. But hurry, because it must end Sunday. Celebrate. There's 50% off, and whatever you choose, there's 4 years free credit and everything's free for a year. So celebrate and save with 50% off the springtime collection at DFS. But hurry, it must end 5 p.m. Sunday.
The frizz monster can strike at any time. So try new Sunsilk Frizz Control Cream. Be prepared. Tame your frizz.
The stars in their eyes, kids, a live vinyl is at 6:30. Right now on ITV1, though, watch out. There's a con artist in town.
Hey.
Hello, Moto.